Okay, so here we're continuing this exercise where A is equal to negative 3. Let me write this down. We're already told this in the problem. B is equal to 2, C is equal to 5, and D is equal to negative 4. And we're told to plug these values into these expressions. So this first expression, which I'll write down, is 3 times B over D. And if I plug in what we know, we get 3 times 2, which is B, over D, which is negative 4. If I evaluate this, I get 6 over negative 4, and I can reduce that. I can get that as 3 over negative 2. But you could also write this as negative 3 over positive 2, same result. Or a negative sign right in the middle, negative 3 over 2. So we have a lot of flexibility there. In the next problem, this one tells us, well, A minus 4B over 3C plus 2D. And all this means is on the top we'll have negative 3 minus 4 times 2 over 3 times 5 plus 2 times negative 4. I'm just plugging in the variables that we're being given here. And we get negative 3 minus 8, which is negative 11. And here we get 15 plus negative 8. If I simplify that, I get negative 11 over 7. I can leave it there because I have two numbers that have no common factors. And now in the next one, we have 1 over A plus B. And we know A and B, well, that's 1 over negative 3 plus 2. Negative 3 plus 2 is negative 1. So again, we can write this as 1 over negative 1. We can write this as negative 1 over 1, or 1 over 1, and then putting the negative sign here. Okay, last we have A, B over C, D. Okay, well that means A times B over C times D. And A is negative 3 times B is 2 over C, which is 5 times D, which is negative 4. So really that's like negative 6 over negative 20, right? And if I reduce this, I get it's going to be a positive result dividing two negatives, and we'll get 3 over 10. And that's my answer for that one. All right, hope that helped.